Hey, I'm Bob at I Like to Make Stuff. Today we're going to use 3D printing to make custom sanding blocks. First, let me say that these are inspired by an existing product sold by Lee Valley. I'm gonna link them down in the description. I'm not trying to take away business from them at all, but when I saw these, I realized that they were a perfect candidate for a specific 3D printed part. You may be wondering why you would need these things. Well, a couple of reasons. One, if you 3D printed a part that had a very specific inside corner that you needed to sand, you could make the matching sander to fit right in the 3D software. But even more generally, in woodworking, if you have an inside curve or an inside corner of a specific angle and you want to make a sander to match just that specific spot, this is the way you do it. The coolest part is that the modeling for this is extremely simple. In fact, you really only need to work in two dimensions. Let me show you how I did it.
I started in Illustrator, but you could use anything that can create 2D graphics, like InkScape. That's a free option. I just made one half of each one of the shapes that I wanted to make, and then mirrored them. So I made three different types of shapes, copied them, flipped them over horizontally, and then lined them up with the original shape. I removed the center line so that it combined down to a single outline. I made sure that all of the holes were closed up and it was a solid line, and then exported this file as an SVG file. I opened up Fusion and used the insert tool to bring my SVG in as a sketch. From there, I grabbed all the sketch lines and extruded them into a 3D shape, and it was ready to go. From here, you can do anything you want to in the modeling software, but it really didn't need anything, so I sent it directly out as an STL file to my slicing software, and from there, sent it directly to the 3D printer. These printed very quickly, and all I had to do was cut off the raft that held it to the build plate using a sharp knife. These are going to be wrapped with sandpaper, so you can use the lowest quality settings and make them print very quickly. After I got these cut off, I checked out the different shapes, and I think they're going to work out pretty well. You're gonna want the sandpaper as tight as possible to the surface, so if you can't pull it tightly with your hand, you could cover it in spray adhesive and push on the sandpaper on every surface. I did a couple of tests so that you can see exactly the imprint that each one of these leaves. This was the round over, and this is the one with a little bit more of a point to it.
These work extremely well, and the possibilities of shape are endless. Like I was saying before, these work great for woodworking. You can make them longer, you can make them taller, or any shape that you want to work with a specific thing that you need to sand. But I also think that making sanding blocks for 3D printed parts is a super cool idea. Imagine that I took this in 3D modeling software and I made this thing, but I wanted to be able to sand this specific area right here. With the model in this position, I could take another block, insert it here, and cut away this shape, leaving just the negative space here. I could print that space out and make a sander that fit just in that area. If you have a really complex 3D model that you need to sand some details in, that would be a fantastic way to be able to sand really precisely in a specific area. I would show you that, but I don't actually have any specific thing like that I need to sand at the moment, and you get the general idea. The print time on these is actually really, really short, and it changes based on how thick you want them and how solid you want the infill to be. You want it to have a little bit of infill because you are going to be pressing on it and you're going to be squeezing it, so you don't want it to crush. But for me, I printed all of these in about 30 minutes. It didn't take very long. And with a short print time like that, it's no big deal to have a whole bunch of different variations of this in your shop ready to go whenever you need them. I hope that was helpful. I'm just trying to give you guys some realistic ways to use 3D printing in your shops, whether it's woodworking or prop making or whatever else. I'd love to know what you think about this one. You can let me know down in the comments. I've got lots of other 3D printing and woodworking and a bunch of other types of videos, so be sure to go check those out. Don't forget to subscribe. That's it for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.